feel like it's usually on the side missions too, where like it would annoy you most. It's like you just want to get this random stupid mission done, and then it's just like, no, I'm just gonna stop working on the stream. Keep the combo going. Well, good thing I'm good at that on this track. Did you just, like, is it the lighter or something? Because it was down a second ago, but I fixed it. Yeah, how? Yeah, the Hammer Brother has a funny voice. Yo-ho, no-ho, near the hooks I'll never go. Oh, I could have got him. It didn't hit him because of something else. Mario, you bitch. I had that. Okay. I haven't paid attention to my coin count. I feel like I still don't do a great job of that, even without the screen being covered now. I don't know, I just don't pay attention. usually 2 down after I do a finish the race. Honestly, I wonder how these four tracks will translate to Mario Kart 8, because, like, I feel like they're somewhat simplistic in design compared to most regular Mario Kart tracks, because they're designed for this game. So, like, I wonder, like, if they'll just combine multiple versions of the same track, or, like, something else. This seems kind of weird to adapt the designs. The tracks are also rather short, so they'd kind of have to make them longer to fit the game. Wow, I'm just getting these prizes like nothing. Oh! Cool. I never used that card though. Why isn't he in Mario Kart 8? Oh yeah, I forgot it wants me to hit it when it reaches two. Not one. I usually just do it at one. Yeah, I can't really think of a good spot for the mushroom. Other than, I guess, right here. I wanted to do that at first, but I thought that might be too late, because it just got to the track. That was close. Oh, bruh, already? Okay, well, stream intermission time. I'm gonna eat some lunch. Oh, wait, actually, I still have to do the coin thing. Never mind. Forgot about this. Not yet. We gotta give it a coin thing. How long have I even been streaming for? Like 20 minutes? 30 minutes? I feel like it was shorter this time. Yeah. I guess I got a lot of more coins than usual. Oh yeah, it's only 1:48. I started at like 1:10. Holy crap, I just killed everyone. Oh yeah, this part kind of fits Toad, actually. Also, did you hear the freaking Toad voice I posted the other day in the gaming channel? Freaking Mario Strikers Toad voice. It was so cringy. I don't even remember that voice in the game, but it's been so long since I played Strikers, so... It's funny to hear the cringy Toad. That's quite possibly the worst Toad voice I've ever heard. To me, I like all of the Toad voices, except for that one, because, like... I mean, the one we have right now is iconic, then we got, like, the Super Show, which is, like, you know, pretty goated. And then we have, like, Mario Party, which is kind of cringy, but it's, like... Kind of funny. I mean, he's like, Yahoo! In like a funny way. And then we got Mario Kart 64, which is just like, which is funny, so. They all work in their own way. They're charming. I like Toad. I think he's underrated. Like, plenty of people hate him. I like him. He's a swell guy. Oh yeah, gotta do that one. More Yahoo voices. Yo ho! And I also find it funny that Rosalina's had like 3 different voice actors throughout the like 15 years that Mario Galaxy has existed. Well, meanwhile, Daisy has had one. Basically, almost the entire time. I mean, except for, like, the Mario Tennis 64 voice, which is different. And then, like, Mario Party 3 and Mario Party 4, which is the same voice as Peach at the time. Except, you know, in a different tone, because... I mean, same voice actor, but different, you know, clips. Oh, we're Roy Koopa again. Yeah, basically. Well, actually, I mean, Luigi was just literally the same Mario clips, except high-pitched in Melee and Smash 64, anyway. And, Mario Kart... a different guy, and not Charles Martinet, but he kinda sounds funny. Well, not Mario Kart 64, I mean the Japanese version, because for some reason, they thought she used, like, the Mario Kart 64 Japanese voices in all versions of Mario Party, even though they changed the voices for the English version. Like, imagine the alternate timeline we would get for the Mario Party 64, if none of the voices were the Mario Kart 64 Japanese. Like, we wouldn't have the iconic Wario, No, I wish! Or whatever. Like, it'd be a lot different. I wonder if anyone's ever attempted a mod. Changing the voices, but, like, they all have equivalent voice clips. Because it's all just reused for Mario Kart 64. Just use the same sound effects that would have been used in the US version instead. Bruh, come on. Yeah. Come on. Also, apparently, Bowser's Roar in Mario 64 is from freaking a King Kong movie. So, there's your King Kong connection. For no reason. Okay. Intermission time, after I collect all of that. And maybe I should pull for Mario, I kinda like him. I think he's a swell guy. Though I should probably wait till the gold pipe to pull anything. Because I don't usually get anything cool, but you never know. Oh, Golf of Mario is not out yet. I'm sad though. Why am I able to play with him then? They lied to me. Why is there CPUs that have Golf Mario? Is Nintendo just lying now about what card setups people have? Or maybe that's just from the daily. I don't, who knows? Oh, yeah. I see. I guess people got lucky then. And got that instead of charging Chuck. Honestly, I kinda wanna go for both, but I don't know the rates on these things. Not sure if it's good or bad. Okay, well, I'm gonna tune out. Wait, what? I thought I was... What the heck? I thought I was stuff people had. Like, why would I take people's names if it's not actually using their cards? That's weird. I thought it would at least, like, take the card data from people. Like, with its pretend multiplayer. Okay, well, break time.